The Punahou Handbook clearly states that the mission of Punahou School includes to enhance creativity, to promote dignity, and to appreciate diversity among students. Uniforms are a possibility being discussed right now. I am opposed to uniforms. If we live by what the mission of Punahou is, then uniforms should not even be an option. With uniforms, being different, having diversity, is not an option. The committee discussing uniforms in the academy are saying that the styles will be white, buff, and blue, baggy collared shirts. So that means if I wear a white shirt on Monday, most likely one third of Punahou will look the exact same as me. That's not being diverse. That's not living by the mission of Punahou. Schools with uniforms are instructionally traditional schools. We are one of the most progressive middle schools in the nation. Why should we go with traditional school methods of uniforms? And the main reason for traditional schools to have uniforms is to curb school violence. Has there ever been school violence here? No. Has there ever been a death over a jacket? No. The only reason for us to have uniforms is because of some dress code violation, which could and should be stopped. The dress code could get stricter, there could be more punishments if you're out of dress code. We should enforce the dress code before uniforms even become an option. For some girls, school uniforms will make being popular a competition of who is the nicest, most expensive, jackets, shoes, and accessories. There have been studies to show that the main reason parents want uniforms is so that their son or daughter won't feel so pressured about how they look or get teased about how they dress. But uniforms won't fix that. Instead of wearing $30 t-shirts, some girls will compete with $100 accessories. So it won't always save parents money. Some girls will do whatever they can to go against dress code, like rolling up their shorts. So the competition of how you look won't stop. There is no point in uniforms if we don't understand our responsibility to dress appropriately wherever we go. For 6 hours a day, we will wear uniforms. But after school, over the weekend, at the movies, we will wear whatever we want. If we don't learn to dress sensibly wherever we go, why should uniforms? Dressing without a choice. Change what we wear at the times when we do have a choice. The Punahou Handbook clearly states that the mission of Punahou School includes to enhance creativity, to promote dignity, and to appreciate diversity among students. Diversity, being different, doesn't come in three colors.
Good morning, everyone. I have a question for you. What comes to your mind when you think of a vegetarian? A small, skinny, carrot-gnawing, fruit-slurping weirdo? Kind of like me? Well, think again. What do horses, rhinos, elephants, and gorillas have in common? They're all walking powerhouses, and you guessed it, they're vegetarians. The fact is, human bodies are much more like plant eaters or herbivores than carnivores. Carnivores have claws and sharp pointed front teeth. Plant eaters and humans don't. Carnivores have intestinal tracts that are one third the length of herbivores and humans, allowing them to get all of that decomposing meat out of their bodies quickly. In us, it sits and rots and releases toxins. Which brings me to the health benefits of being a vegetarian. According to the American Medical Association, 90 to 97% of heart disease would be prevented by a vegetarian diet. Our bodies just can't handle all of that animal fat and cholesterol, so plaque builds up in our arteries and causes heart attacks and strokes. Studies also link cancer to meat eating, kidney disease too. Kidneys rid our body of toxins, but so much meat in the diet overworks them and they fail. Speaking of toxins, these animals we eat are full of tranquilizers, antibiotics, hormones, and 2,700 other chemicals and drugs. There's sodium nitrate that is used to make the meat look nice and red instead of the unappetizing, scabby, gray-brown color of a dead body. There's diethylstilbestrol, a growth hormone that for health reasons has been banned in 32 countries. Also, the meat industry is infamous for not enforcing proper health standards. Carcasses are often contaminated with cockroaches, rat stool, and rust. Yeah, but what about protein, people always say. According to the American Medical Association, all the protein we need is in grains, beans, nuts, and vegetables. And in fact, too much protein is far more often the problem than not enough. Yale University studies show that too much protein, quote, reduces the body's energy and its ability to recover from fatigue, unquote. Now here's an economic consideration. Listen to these figures. Over 90% of all grain produced in America goes to feeding livestock. For every 16 pounds of grain that is fed to cattle, we only get 1 pound of meat back. We actually produce enough food for everyone on the planet, but we feed it to the animals, and then we eat them. Then, of course, there's the ethical considerations, that being a vegetarian is just a more humane way of life. Some might say, well, you vegetarians, you rip apart the head of the cauliflower, and you cut out the heart of the artichoke, and with your teeth, you tear into the tender flesh of the helpless fruit, and you crush open the poor, defenseless nut for its meat. Come on, most of us would have to admit, there is a difference. Russian author Leo Tolstoy believed that by killing animals, man suppresses in himself sympathy and pity towards living creatures, and by violating his own feelings, becomes cruel. Great men throughout the ages were vegetarians. The mathematician Pythagoras, the famous playwright George Bernard Shaw, Benjamin Franklin, Leonardo da Vinci, to name just a few. Well, that's all that time allows, but I hope I've left you with a little food for thought, with a few meaty ideas that you can really sink your teeth into.